This is your Monex Metals Market Update with Mike Maroney.
Good afternoon. It's Monday, July 31st. My name is Mike Maroney, and I am coming to you today from the Monex Precious Metals Studio. Let's do our week in preview. And typically what we do before we talk about what sits out on the horizon, a lot of times what we do is we review what took place and how the markets have actually reacted to it. And the big news really last week was the Fed and their decision to leave interest rates alone. But what they also did when they made that decision was insinuate that QE was over, of course, but QT was about to begin. Now the question is, how will the markets react to QT? Now, QT is an acronym for quantitative tightening. The Fed is currently sitting on approximately $4.66 trillion worth of government paper and mortgage-backed securities. And needless to say, what happened between 2008 and 2012 was a massive increase in the overall money supply. Now, what is that increase in the money supply actually achieved? It didn't cause the type of inflation that the Fed would like to see, but it obviously has caused asset inflation. And if you look around, you'll find that most real estate prices around the United States are back or very close to the 2007-2008 highs, and some are making new all-time highs. And a lot of that is based on the fact that there's a lot of cheap money still out there where people are able to lock in loans well below 4% on 30-year and on shorter term loans, 15-year and less, you can lock in somewhere below 3%, which is historically low levels. And when you consider that most people, as far as real estate purchasers are concerned, they're not buying price, they're buying payment. And as interest rates go up, payments go up, price typically goes down. With quantitative tightening, you know, we will inevitably see the Fed selling mortgage-backed securities and selling government treasuries. And in order to do that, typically they have to induce buyers back into the game. And in order to do that, interest rates usually go higher. And the stock market making new all-time highs, even in a economy where GDP growth is right around 2%. And when you look at the driving force behind the moves in stocks, it's no wonder that corporations, which have been able to borrow at incredibly low rates, have bought back a lot of their stock. A matter of fact, 18% of the volume they consider as far as the buy side volume has been through corporate buyback, which has pushed the value of the stock market higher and higher. Now, the interesting thing is what we've experienced since January, February is a precipitous drop in the value of the US dollar. The dollar went from 104.5 all the way down to 93.08 last week, and today it looks like it may be taking out key support right around 93. Have we suddenly seen a perception change where reality is coming home to roost? Because the long-term prospects as far as the dollar are concerned are much weaker. And when you think about what we have to deal with as far as debt, as far as pensions, as far as state debt, state pensions are concerned, it's no wonder the rest of the world is a little bit concerned with the value of the greenback, which the US has been willing to print and print. Are we in the beginning stages of a major free fall as far as the US dollar is concerned? Are we in the beginning stages of a topping pattern in both real estate and in the stock market? And are we starting to see money move back into commodities? We've seen major moves up in copper, we've seen major moves in the grains, and it looks like the precious metals are just starting to heat up. Silver was at 1505 a few weeks back. It's all the way up to 1680 now. And if we can get through key resistance right around that 1685 price, we could be off to the races. Gold was down at 1207. We've traded as high as 1275. And most people will tell you if this thing breaks above 1297, look out. There's a good chance we could easily see 1400 before the end of the year. But with everything that's happening in the world today and the prospects of quantitative tightening, something that we have never seen before because quantitative easing was new. Now they're going the opposite direction. Quantitative easing helped. Will quantitative tightening cause major volatility in other markets, causing safe haven investors to move into gold and silver? Now may be one of the best times in years to own precious metals. Give us a call so we can talk about how you can add precious metals to your portfolio, not only for protection, but also for profit. Thank you.